Welcome, everyone. Come on in. It's time for the Tammy Faye Show. It's a time of fun-filled inspiration. So don't turn that dial. We're about to begin.
To Betty,
yes.
And it's happy birthday time to Roger. So let's go. And we're going to have a party, and you are invited to our party. We have the puppets here tonight from the Worship and Drama Ministries of the Youth Group from First Assembly of God. In now, us Northerners would say it humble, but he, the, but Bill and Paula Stringer told me you don't put the H on, Tammy, in Texas. You say humble. So
humble.
This is the first AG in humble.
They're proud of humble.
Yes, and their puppets are here, and their puppets are so much fun. So moms, run and get your kids if the kids are anywhere around, because they're going to love the puppets tonight. We're going to have a really fun time, so you want to stay tuned. Now, we got to let you know who's all here. We have Barb and Raj here, who are here every single week. Over here, yes, is Raj's brother, John. And Roger's sister-in-law,
Vivian.
Viv. And then over here, we have
the birthday
girl. Betty and Joey, our birthday girl. And she's all dressed up in her mommy's clothes. And Joey says he would like to take her home with him.
I think I will.
So we're going to have a real fun time. But first of all, Joey, you need to go to the piano, because we're going to sing happy birthday to these two birthday kids. And so being that, you know, it always, you know, like when birthday and Christmas happen on the same time, you know, like my sister, her birthday is like on the 25th, and so is Christmas. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and they always have to get, you know, they don't get double. You just get Merry Christmas and Happy Birthday, which is really the pits. So we're going to sing Happy Birthday to each one individually, so they'll both feel special. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Betty. Happy birthday to you. Oh, is it too cute? Now, it's your turn, Rod. It's your turn. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. I think I better get right into it before you think that maybe this is just that this all is not really real. But it is birthday time, and I think birthday times are so fun. And for you at home who are having a birthday this week, happy birthday to you, and we hope you have a wonderful, wonderful birthday. You know, birthdays are special, I think. I think birthdays are so special. We always celebrated birthdays around our house. We'd celebrate all week long. And just all week long, we just happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. And that's a fun way to do it. And so,
on my birthday, we have two sons. On each one of our birthdays, Betty used to say, yes, excuse me.
Betty used to say, you need a mic.
I have two sons on my birthday. Anyway, Betty used to say, whatever you want me to cook for birthday, I'll cook it.
Yeah.
My favorite was German chocolate cake. Homemade German chocolate cake and fried chicken. Southern fried chicken.
Until he got cholesterol.
And then he had.
And then Dr. Cherry told me I couldn't do that anymore.
Well,
so
that cholesterol came from just having too many birthdays.
Now, wait a minute.
Now, my mama, we always just let us have what we want on our birthday, too. And so Mama made a steak that she made, put red gravy over. Ooh. And so on my birthday, I always wanted that steak with red gravy over. Oh, that was the best stuff I ever tasted in my whole life.
Yes,
it was so good. And then Grandma used to make a special cake. And it, well, I have never tasted a cake like it, but she made a cake. It was like a sponge cake, but it wasn't a sponge cake. And it was, oh, that was the best cake I ever ate in my life. And what did you have on your birthday, John? What was your special thing?
They gave me peanut butter.
Is that all you got was peanut butter?
Chocolate.
Chocolate.
He's a chocoholic.
Has to be chocolate.
Chocolate. What about you, Viv?
I like chocolate.
You like chocolate on your birthday, too? Okay.
Candy.
And what do you like on your
pecan
birthday?
Pecan pie.
Pecan pie.
Pecan.
Barbara likes marshmallows on her birthday. Bro, what do you like on your birthday, honey?
Cats.
Nuts. He does. He likes nuts. Anything with nuts on it. Well, how about this? I think I'm going to go over. Can I go over and sing with the gang?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do it.
I'm going to stand up. I got to warn them when I stand up. This is birthday time. And so I'm going to sing with the gang. Are you guys there?
Are you sure?
They're here. They said they're here. So are you ready?
We are ready.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Yes, yes. If life hands you a lemon, what do you do? What do you do, guys? Start making lemonade.
If life hands you a lemon, you start making lemonade. If the heat of the day gets a little too hot, you just start thinking shade. You thank God for the situation, and you praise Him for the day He made. If life hands you a lemon, you start making lemonade. Ah, you start making lemonade. You know, we all get sidetracked just to making those plans of what we want to be and do. And you know, all too often we don't even consult God about what He has in mind for me and you. You know, we plot and we scheme and we struggle and we fret. Then we're amazed when we're pruned by God's blade. But you know what He's trying to tell us is that when life hands us a lemon, turn that lemon into lemonade. If life hands you a lemon, start making lemonade. If the heat of the day gets a little too hot, you just start thinking shade. You thank God for the situation, and you praise Him for the day He made. If life hands you a lemon, ah, you start making lemonade. Yeah, you start making lemonade. Come on now, we need a little bit more sugar poured in. Come on. Oh, oh yes, I think we got a little lemon up there. You know, there's times when we think we've hit our highest low yet, and there's nothing left to go wrong. And you know, we're just sure that the old devil, he's been working overtime to sneak in and steal our happy song. You know, there's two things you can do when we're put to the test and we think that we just can't make the grade. You know, we can throw in the towel and just run off and hide, or turn that lemon into lemonade. When life hands you a lemon, start making lemonade. When the heat of the day gets a little too hot, you just start thinking shade. You thank God for the situation, and you praise Him for the day He made. Praise the Lord when life hands you a lemon.
And a whole bunch of stuff right after this message. Don't go away.
Thousands of forest fires are started by people who never realize what they've done. Some never even set foot in the forest.
Hi, everyone. You know what? Channel 22 has a brand new show, and it's called The Tammy Faye Show. Now, we'd just love for you to come down and be part of our live studio audience. It'll be a time of fun-filled inspiration for the whole family. Yes, that's right. The whole family is welcome, kids and all. We're located at 1050 Gemini Boulevard in Clear Lake. Call Karen at 713-212-1077.
There are no signs, no warnings. Anyone can have a cholesterol number that's high. In other words, if your cholesterol number is too high, you could have a heart attack or worse. Luckily, there's something you could do about it. For your own good, remember what Ben Franklin would have said. Knowledge is a key to good health. Have your cholesterol level checked and know what your number means to you.
And we're going to put on hats. There you go. Everybody's got to put their hat on now. Make sure, yeah, your rubber band's up there. Everybody stick it on now. Okay, got to have a whistle, too. We're going to get a whistle. Here you are, Mark. Here you are, all these puppeteers. There you go. Oh, yours broke. Well, let's try another one here.
I like white better.
Okay. Put that one on the bottom. Careful when you pull your string, guys. Careful when you pull your string. If it breaks, we got another one. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. I bet you want there to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Here, Tina. Whoops. Here, Tina. Happy birthday. Tina is one of my favorite people in the whole world. She comes to our program. Stand up, Tina. Stand up. And she's the one who gets everything ready. She takes care of me. Thank you, Tina. I love you. She takes care of me. She makes sure that we have something to drink on the set. She makes me handkerchiefs. She made our aprons. She just does all sorts of wonderful things. We love you, Tina. Oh, we can't give guys that. You gotta hit. There you go. Batman. Ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Here you. Whoops. There you go. There you go, honey. Okay, here's a Batman. Oh, we gotta get a girl's one. There's a girl's one. Okay, everybody's got their whistles. Blow! Oh, wow! Yeah! Okay, I think that every one of us ought to be a child once in a while. I think it wouldn't hurt one bit for some of us staid adults to become a child once in a while, blow a whistle, wear a funny hat, go out and do something that we haven't done since we were little kids, eat a hot dog, go to a ball game, eat some popcorn, just do some fun things, you know? So many of us adults, we get so staid. I won't never be accused of that. Because I have a little kid in me that's never going to go away. But I think everybody would be happier if they had a little kid in them that wouldn't go away, don't you? Well, I'm going to go out and talk to this gang. Are they there? Is the gang not there? Are they going to wear their hats?
Yeah.
Okay, go check on them. The kids are going to go check on the gang. I need a little, Thanks, Barbie. Where are you?
Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness!
All right, what is your name?
Penelope!
Penelope. This is, yes, Penelope. You know, you remind me a little bit of Susie Moppet, Penelope.
Oh, Susie Moppet!
Oh, my goodness!
She? I haven't seen 8 years.
And what are you?
I'm Miss Yvonne.
Miss, this is Miss Yvonne. Now, you must have a real good outlook on life, Miss Yvonne.
Oh, I love life.
I mean, would you look at this gal? I mean, she has her necklace on here.
Oh, well,
look at these wings. Are these, well.
Ain't I gorgeous?
Well, leave them over there. They're really pretty. See, show them off a little bit.
Wait for
me. Oh, that's
me.
Wonderful. And then, well, now, who are you?
My name's Priscilla.
This is Priscilla.
Yes.
Priscilla, you sort of have a back problem, don't you?
Yeah, I do. You know what, Miss Tammy?
What, dear?
I would love it if Brother McDuff came over here so I could pet his hair.
Come here, Rod. She wants to pet your hair. Pet his hair? Oh, he's going to come. He's going to come. Okay.
Yay.
Okay, here it is. She would like to pet your hair, Rod. Okay.
This is her dream.
Yes, I'm so excited.
Oh. That's it.
That was so fun. It was like petting my little poodle dog, Fifi.
It was like petting Fifi, huh?
Yes.
Well, I'm sure Roger will be very happy to hear that. Okay, now, there's some other guys around here somewhere. Where are the rest of you? Yoo-hoo. There should be some up. Where are you?
Come on!
Where are you? Is there? There's a gang back there, believe me, because I saw them come out before.
Hello?
Oh, there's one. What's your name?
My name is...
Socrates.
Yes, that's right. Socrates.
Suck it to me, right? And who else is back there now? Have you got a friend back there? Oh, yeah, here's the line.
That's Wooly!
What's your name?
I ain't got no name.
Where did he come from? He's an imposter.
Imposter!
How in the world is that?
What happened to Wooly?
Oh, dear. Now, there's a sippy one coming right out from here pretty soon.
Penelope, we got a friend, Penelope.
Well, where is she?
Oh, here's Penelope, right here.
Where?
What here?
Oh, well.
I'm over here.
Who's this?
That's Tamisha.
That's Tamisha!
Oh, I just found somebody else back here.
Hi, Tamisha!
Hello. How you doing? It's really good to see y'all.
Why, you're quite good at that.
Well, whoops, my, there.
Well, here, let me get that off you.
Yeah, is that
okay.
Better?
Now there it works. I did this for many years.
And you
I'm
do
so
well.
Happy to have you with us.
But I wasn't black then, I was white.
Imagine that. How on earth did that happen?
I don't know.
And I had blonde hair instead of black.
Blonde?
Yep. But I like being black. Black is beautiful.
It sure is.
Yeah.
God just toasted you a little longer.
He toasted
you? Yes!
He sure did.
Wow.
What's the matter with you up there?
This is terrific.
Isn't this wonderful?
Like live TV.
Yeah,
wow.
It sure is. I don't know if it's making
We're
any sense.
We're having a party. Wow.
I love parties. Like
Me
I go.
Me too.
Bye-bye, honey. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. See you later.
I love
it. Oh, we got a little behind the scenes there. This is really fun. Now, the puppets have a song they're going
to
sing for us. And
yes,
what are you all singing?
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Kind of like
it is
happy
a happy
birthday.
Day today. It's a happy birthday day. Yeah. Take it away. Right after this message, okay? See you back.
You are listening to the heartbeat of an unborn baby 28 days after conception. Abortion stops a beating heart. Help us stop abortion. Stay informed about all the issues in the pro-life movement. Call 1-800-854-6100 right now to receive a free copy of the National Right to Life News and find out how you can help save lives. Call now. Stop abortion.
Hi, I'm Tammy Faye. You know, lately so many people have come up to me and said, Tammy, do you have any more of your albums available? I've worn mine out. And so today I'd like to make my newest album available to you. It's called Love, Tammy. I think you'll enjoy The Samaritan Man, It's Mercy Time, Precious Healing, and many more. To order your tape, you may write me at Box 245 Rancho Mirage, California, 92270. A check for $12 will cover the shipping and handling.
What's for dinner? It's pickled herring, smoked salmon, and liver paste.
Your family will begin a wonderful adventure when you open your home and your hearts to a foreign exchange student. Become a host family and help make way for a peaceful global tomorrow. Make friends with the world. One friendship at a time.
Guess what's for dinner? Pizza?
American Intercultural Student Exchange. Call toll-free 1-800-SIBLING.
And blow. So come on, birthday children. They're gonna, Roger and Betty are gonna come and make a wish. You gotta make a wish and then blow, okay? Are you ready? Okay, ready, set. Have you got a wish?
Yes.
Okay, okay. Go, blow. Cake, and we're going to give everybody a piece of cake, and I wish you were here at home so that you could have a piece of cake, too. I think the most wonderful things about birthdays is having the cake, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I love the cake. I love the frosting so sweet that it tickles your teeth.
It's like the frosting that makes your mouth blue.
Oh, that makes it blue?
Yeah, that's chocolate.
Chocolate.
Oh, that's chocolate. No, it's white with blue coloring.
Okay, here we go. Here we go. Boy, look at how I can cut through this. Man, am I a good birthday cake cutter or what?
You are. You're wonderful.
Look at that. I mean, can you believe that's from years of experience? Okay, now, Barb, we got to give to the birthday kids first.
Okay.
So give this to one of them.
Ladies first.
And then, you know, I always like the rose because it has all that extra sugar in it.
Over there.
All right, now we're going to deliver to the studio audience each a piece of birthday cake. Whoops, dip back there. Okay. Okay, and a napkin. Okay. Okay.
Let's see. Let me get over here. You put the cake on there. And then
okay,
I'll grab
Barb.
The napkin.
Okay, that's good. You get the napkin, and then I'll. Oh, this is fun.
Put the forks over here.
Isn't this fun? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Roger and Betty. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you there at home. Is this good stuff? It looks good. It looks like that real white wedding cake type stuff. Nummy, nummy. I love it when it's white like wedding cake, you know? Oh! We're letting Roger be a little boy today, so he can't quite find his mouth. He can't quite find his mouth, Roger can't.
That's what little boys do when they have their first party. You give them the cake and
that's
they just
right.
dive in.
That's
it.
What little boys do. They just dive into it. It's a good thing this is our last program today. Oh, this is so good. I can't wait. Ooh, is that good? You want to try some? That is wonderful. Ooh, yo!
Oh, let's see.
Huh? Oh, my good cook? Oh, thank you. Worked all day long on this cake.
No, hand me some more forks, please. Forks.
Oh, forks.
Yeah, down.
We want to say happy birthday to everyone at home.
Yeah.
Who's having a birthday this week or this month, happy birthday to you. This is really good. One for the studio audience and one for me. A bite for the studio audience and a bite for me. I'm hungry.
Let's see, we're running out of forks. Grab a fork.
There's a lot more forks here.
Oh, it's
a lot
more.
Head back there.
Oh, yeah, I got it.
Now, how many more do we have out there? We have to get the crew some, too. Don't forget the crew. They might take us off the air if we would get the crew. They just shut right down.
They can go black, huh?
Yeah. Say, they might just walk off their cameras and refuse to...
Here, babe.
I gotta have something.
Here.
Okay. Now, honey, are we out of plates? We got more plates.
We got more plates.
Do you hear what Joey's playing? Did you notice it?
No.
He's playing a song. It sounds like I Want to Wish You a Merry Christmas, but we just rewrote it.
Yeah.
And we're going, I Want to Wish You a Happy Birthday.
Oh, that's good.
All right?
That's good. Sing it. Sing it, babe.
I want to wish you a happy birthday. I want to wish you a happy birthday. I want to wish you a happy birthday from the bottom.
What are we going to do for the rest of the show?
Choke.
We're going to be sticky. We should have thought about something to drink. This is... Didn't blow the roof of my mouth, honey. Yes, Rog, can you... I don't know if you can sing with your mouth full, can you? You can? Okay, Roger's going to sing for us. This is so good. I want to get this to people at home. Open up at home. Where are you? Come on, open wide. Take a big bite.
Get your fingers in it.
Are you there?
Did you get some, baby?
Nummy.
You need help. You can help.
No. Thank you, Tina.
Are we ready? All right. Let's have a party. We're in New Orleans tonight, when Judgment Day is a-drawing nigh. Where shall I be, with the works of men shall try? Where shall I be? Where shall I be? Where shall I be, when it sounds so loud? When it sounds so loud that it wakes up the dead. Where shall I be when it sounds? Now here we go. Where shall I be when the first trumpet sounds? Now you help me. Where shall I be when it sounds so? You got a red mouth. When it sounds so loud that it wakes up the dead. Where shall I be when it sounds? Now we're gonna play now. Here we go. Let's have a party. Hallelujah. All right. What happened to your neck? When east and west of Fisheru, where shall I be? And how will it be with my poor soul? Where shall I be? Now come on, everybody sing with me. Come on, hound dog. Where shall I be when the first trumpet sound? Where shall I be
when it sounds so loud?
You're loud. It sounds so loud that it wakes up the dead. Where shall I be when it sounds? Now everybody, here we go. Let's together, here we go. Where shall I be
when the trumpet shall sound? I don't know. When it sounds,
get it,
so loud.
When it sounds so loud that it wakes up the dead. Where shall I be when it sounds? We're gonna play now. Here we go. You sure are good looking. I bet you. Yeah!
I don't know what's going on, but where is it that it is that we worked on, Mr. Engineer? Yay! Now that, Tammy, that was my sidekick on my television show.
That was your sidekick.
That was Mumps.
Your Susie Moppet, right?
Yeah.
He was kind
of
cute.
Hey. Go ahead, Tammy. It's yours.
It's mine. Okay. Well, we're glad to have you back over on this side. Boy, I'll tell you, we are keeping the cameramen working today. But now they've all had a big piece of birthday cake, and they're raring to go again. Yep, they gave me the thumbs up, said, it's all ready. Let's go. How much time do we have left, folks? I don't know where I am. Have no earthly idea.
You're in Houston, Texas.
I'm in Houston, Texas, and I go have to give a break. Okay. Okay, we're gonna go for a break. When we come back, we're gonna talk to Roe. Okay, be right back.
Mom, easy on the brakes.
Looks like you're having a rough ride.
No kidding. You think she know how to drive.
Yeah, you'll be okay. She really loves you. You're buckled up.
Yeah, I'll give her credit. And your mom, too.
Oh, I insist. We don't leave home without it.
Whoa, here we go again.
Parents, love your kids. Buckle them up.
Hi, I'm Tammy Faye. You know, lately so many people have come up to me and said, Tammy, do you have any more of your albums available? I've worn mine out. And so today I'd like to make my newest album available to you. It's called Love, Tammy. I think you'll enjoy The Samaritan Man, It's Mercy Time, Precious Healing, and many more. To order your tape, you may write me at Box 245, Rancho Mirage, California, 92270. A check for $12 will cover the shipping and handling.
Without the men and women of the National Guard and Reserve, 44% of our nation's defense just wouldn't be there. So be a hero. Give your employees the freedom to protect ours.
You got there. Explain that hat to us a little bit.
I don't know. I just picked it up. Somebody, I believe it was my brother John, gave me a genuine antique.
Oh. Yes, that you are, my brother. What does it say? It says, I've been there, done that.
Been there, done that, and can't remember.
Oh, I'll tell you, it takes a strong person with a strong constitution to grow old, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. I don't know. I haven't grown up yet.
I haven't either.
Tammy, George Burns one time said, do you know how you get to be 90? How to be 100 years old? He said, you get to 99.
Yeah.
And then you're very careful.
I'd like to introduce you to the most special man in my life. I love this man so much, my husband, Roe Messner. Love you, baby.
Thank you.
I want Ro to tell you a little bit about where he came from. Ro, tell us a little bit about how you grew up, and where your roots were from.
Well, I grew up on the farm.
You grew up on the farm as a farm boy.
I was born down in Oklahoma.
Uh huh.
And grew up on the farm. We got up at daylight and work till dark, and that's sort of been the way I was raised.
Now, were you from a very wealthy family?
No.
Tell us what your family was like.
My folks were farmers.
Yeah.
And we didn't have electric lights. Mm-hmm. We didn't have indoor plumbing.
Uh-huh.
I was in the third grade I knew anything about indoor plumbing or bathrooms or anything like that.
Where'd you go? I mean,
we had an outhouse.
Okay. Wherever you wanted, right?
Behind any tree, anyway.
Okay.
And so now, your mother and father, what denomination were they?
We was raised in the Assembly of God.
The Assemblies of God.
When I was just a little guy, I remember a picture of my folks holding me in front of the First Assembly of God Church down in Oklahoma.
And so you went to the Assembly of God Church for as long as you've ever remembered,
as
right?
long as I can remember. Uh-huh.
And so as you grew into a teenager, Ro, as you were growing up, tell us what happened. Now you tell about when you got your first car and your first job and all. Tell us all about it. How you tell who you used to stay with. He has a wonderful story. You loved Grandpa, didn't you?
Yeah, my granddad was my favorite person. And I always worked on the farm with him, you know, in the summer. I actually went to work when I was 14 years old.
Uh-huh.
And then in 1953, I went into business for myself.
How old were you then?
I was 18 years old.
And tell us what you did.
I started out building houses, and then a couple years later, I went into church building, and I've been building churches ever since.
Now, tell us about when you first realized there was another part of town.
Wow. Well, you know, I grew up on the wrong side of the tracks, you might say, and I found out very early in life that I wanted to make a change in my life. I didn't want to always live on the other side of the tracks.
Tell us where did you go to where? You went to from the farm to into town school. Tell us
okay.
about that.
All right, I left the farm.
Good thing I know his life story. We'd be in a pickle here. Come on, honey.
You should have told me what we were going to talk about.
You would have boned up on it,
yeah.
huh? Boned up on it. Okay.
We left the farm when I was in the third grade.
Uh-huh.
And we moved to Wichita, Kansas.
That was the big time.
That was a big deal. My dad went to work in an airplane factory mm-hmm. there. That was about 1941, mm-hmm. I think, 42. And so we moved to the big city.
Yeah.
And I started going to the big city school. And then we had plumbing and we had electric lights. And we had all that good stuff.
Whoa. Yeah. Oh, whoa. Yeah.
Way uptown.
Yeah, we got way uptown quick. And so that's sort of how I got started.
Now, Ro, you all your life have taught. When did you start teaching Sunday school?
Well, I started teaching the high school class when I was 14 years
14
old.
14 years old, this man started teaching
and
the high school class.
I had over 60 kids in my class.
You started teaching
and
kids that were older than you.
Well, yes. Yeah, some of them were seniors. I was actually, at that time, I was only, a sophomore. And I taught the class, and I started teaching the young marrieds and the college and your career and then the adults. I taught Sunday school for over 40 years.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. Now, Ro, you every time we ride on an airplane and I'm reading my magazines and things and to try to get over the nervousness of riding on the airplane, I look over at Ro and there's always one thing he's doing. What are you doing, Ro Messner?
Well, I'm always memorizing scripture.
He memorizes scripture. How many scriptures have you memorized, honey?
I don't know.
Hundreds, probably.
Yes, I know a lot of scripture.
Something so cute happened. Ro went over to a minister's church, to a church that was going to build and was wanting Ro to build for them. And so he went over there thinking that he was just going over to talk to them about church building. And before we tell that, tell us how many churches you've built, Ro.
I've built 1,359.
Which equals into what?
I built churches in 47 states,
uh-huh.
and I've been building churches for 38 years.
Averages one church
every 10 days for 38 years.
My goodness.
That's a lot of church building, yeah. baby. You built the biggest church in the United States.
Yes.
He built the biggest church in the United States. Why did you decide to build churches, Ro?
Well, I started building houses, and I had an opportunity to build my first church there in Wichita
uh-huh.
in 1956. And, you know, it just seemed the right thing to do, really.
Uh-huh.
While I was building that church, another local church wanted a building. And before I knew it, I had two churches going.
Uh-huh.
And it just sort of evolved like that.
So Ro probably knows pastors better than anyone in the world. He knows pastors because he works with them at a point in their lives that is very difficult. When a pastor's building a church, it's a very difficult time. And that's the time when a lot of pastors leave. After they get the church built, they leave. They can't take it anymore. But you know pastors, don't you, Ro?
Yes, I think I know pastors better than
anybody else. But anyway, the story I was getting ready to tell you, oh, thank God I'm not too old to remember that. I may be able to go back to it yet. I wonder how that will be next year. But my power of comprehension is still pretty good, Rod. Still pretty good. So I can go back. My memory is still pretty good.
You have a memory?
Yes. Okay. I'm pretty good, yeah.
Where yet?
So I'm trying to think. No. So anyway, Ro went over to this pastor who was going to build a church. And the pastor said to Ro, what did he say to you?
He said, Ro, I want you to preach for me in the morning. This was a Baptist church, a Southern Baptist church up in Oakland, California, about 4 or 5 months ago.
Yeah.
And I went up on Saturday to meet with the committee, and then he wanted me to stay over for Sunday morning and meet the congregation. And he said, he sprung that on me while we were having the meeting that Saturday evening. He said, Ro, now you're gonna speak in the morning. I said, well, I'll get up and say a few words. He said, no, I mean you're gonna preach. I said, I've never done that before in my life. But he said, I said, okay, I'll do it. So I got up and I brought the message and ended up talking for 50 minutes.
That's pretty long-winded old guy here.
Did real good.
And what tickled me was he got more than I get in offering. She got $1,000.
Couldn't believe it.
I was so excited when he come home, I couldn't stand it.
Send him out some more, Tammy.
Oh, yeah, I want to send him out. Anybody would need a preacher. I'll sing. He can.
How many times can you preach a week, Ro?
I can preach every night, I think.
Wonderful thing about Ro is when he gets up, he preaches a scripture. And the scripture, I have never seen this man ever any different than what you see him right here. I have never seen him raise his voice. I have never seen him unhappy. I have never seen him. He is the most even man I've ever met in my life. But every time I go looking for Ro, he's sitting reading scripture somewhere. And honey, do you think that's what keeps you? You never worry. This man never worries. Worry, honey, I scream. But you don't worry, do you, honey?
No, I don't. I don't believe in worrying. My philosophy of life is, first of all, always go play golf every day.
Every day.
I try to get in my golf game every day.
Why do you do that, Ro?
Well,
you smell the roses.
Right? I've learned to smell the roses. Yeah. You can't wait till tomorrow. We only have today. And so yesterday's gone. All we've got is today. So I smell the roses every day.
And he really does.
I make big plans for tomorrow. Never make any small plans. Always make big plans.
Oh, wow.
I always shoot for the moon, and if I miss, I'll hit a star. So I always make big plans. But my philosophy has always been to keep the Lord first in my life.
Yes.
My favorite scripture is Matthew 6:33. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. And I've learned to rely on God's resources in everything I do. You know, I've learned to rely on God's strength. Isaiah 41:10 says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. So God gives us a strength every day that we need.
Praise the Lord.
Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. And another thing that I've learned to rely on God is his faithfulness. You know, you mentioned the pastors that let you down.
Yeah.
And your friends let you down. But you know, the Lord has never let me down once.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lamentations 3:22-23 says, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed.
Amen.
Because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning.
Yes.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Hallelujah.
And we can always depend on the Lord to be faithful, even though our friends let us down. And I've learned to rely on God's peace. You know, when the wheels are coming off and everything's going crazy, it's good to have the peace of God in your heart. Isaiah 26:3 says, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee. So I've learned to keep that peace of God in my heart. You know, 1 Peter 5:7 says, casting all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. You need to learn how to lay your heavy burdens off on the Lord and let Him carry them.
Yes.
And I've learned to rely on God's resources in His provision. You know, when Tammy and I got married, we didn't have anything.
No, we didn't.
We just gone through some pretty difficult times, both of us, the last few years. And we really didn't have any money. We still don't, for that matter. But I've learned to rely on God's provision. Philippians 4:19 says, "But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus." So He'll supply our needs, you know, if we'll just rely on Him and believe in Him. Romans 8:32 says, "He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things?" And so all we've got to do is rely on the Lord, and He'll take care of us. That's sort of been my philosophy.
Hallelujah. He is, Tommy.
Yes.
He carries the label of being the largest church builder in the United States of America.
Yes.
And God has put a man who loves Him in building the Father's
house.
I would like to propose something to folks that are watching out there, wherever you may be. If you would like to, and it's just something that nobody knows I was going to do this, but you would like to see Roe, my brother John and I say John, and Danny Schaefer from Oklahoma City, they played golf, and I drove the buggy. And I watched Danny Schaefer hit a ball and hide it up in a tree, and we couldn't find it nowhere. But anyhow, this man, Roe, is a professional golfer. And how many of you would like to have a golf tournament type thing here in the city of Houston, and we could get Roe to show some of us who do not know how to play golf how to play golf, and we could get Tammy out for a few swings at the ball. Wouldn't that be something? If you'd like to do that, if that interests you, would you write to the station, write to Tammy, and let Tammy know about that? Would you do that? And by the way, if you enjoy this program as much as we enjoy it, would you write to Tammy and say, "Tammy, we love you, and we thank you for being so honest, being so open with your life." And when you do that, would you tuck in a love gift and say, "Tammy, we love you, and we're supporting you." Would you do that? And don't forget, you can get those cassettes, enjoy her music at home, and let Brother Thomas, the man who has founded Channel 22, Elder Thomas, know how much we love him for opening this door. Write and let him know that. Would you do that today?
Roe and I met at a time when both of us were at the depths, really at the depths of despair. And what this man has brought to my life, you know, I'm a type A personality, as I'm sure no one could guess by watching this show. But when this man comes up to me, he turns me into sort of a normal human being. His peace rubs off on me, the wonderful peace that he has. And every time I'm tempted to worry or tempted to get upset or tempted to get frustrated or tempted to cry over what could have been or what old times or the sad things that happened in my life, Roe says, "Honey, we're not living in yesterday.
Amen.
We're living today,
right,
and we're looking forward to what God's going to do tomorrow." And he keeps me level, which I will always thank the Lord for. I think Roe's the man that I've been looking for since I was a little girl, that I have needed to help me to kind of
balance.
Put everything in perspective, to balance me. I've needed him. And we all need balance. I think it's wonderful when a husband and wife balance each other. I think Raj and Barbie balance each other really well, you know. And I see balance. Everywhere I look on our set today, I see husbands and wives that balance each other. And I thank God for a husband that gives me balance. I need that. And thank you, honey.
Thank you.
Tammy.
Yes.
Look what my brother John gave me.
Oh,
read that.
Can I
card.
Read it?
Yes.
Okay, birthday card.
You can read that.
On your birthday, brother, I wish you all the good fortune in the world. And this is a little cat that's kind of a little cat.
He's got a genie.
It's a genie, yeah. You open it up and says, "And when you get it, will you split it with me?" Happy birthday. That's a brother for sure. Oh, my.
Could I just mention something real quick? Roger and I and Roe and John have talked about the possibility of sometime in the future coming to your area of town and doing a live service.
Yes.
You know, if Tammy can make it, you can make it. If Ro can make it, you can make it. And you know, we would like to come to your area of town sometime in the near future.
Yes.
And if you'll keep watching Channel 22, you'll see the announcements. But I think that would be so exciting for you to be able to come out and meet Tammy and Ro and Roger and John and Betty and I, and just have a good time of fellowship.
Yes.
You mentioned that in a program.
Yes.
Of having fellowship.
Yes.
And healing.
And you know, and, yes. And you know what, Joey? I am just fallen in love with Houston. Everywhere I go, people are running up to me and telling me they love me.
Yeah.
And they're so glad we're here.
Good.
And I have felt so welcome here, and thank you for making me feel welcome. I just, a woman, a real shy woman came up to me today, a young lady. I say she was probably about 23, 24, and she put her arms around me and she started to cry. Mm. And she said, "I just love you," and turned around and walked away. And I just thank you so much for making me welcome here. And I want to say hello to the folks in Kentucky.
Louisville,
Kentucky. Hi, we love you too, and we'd love some time to come to your town.
Sure.
And say hello to you. I think the way to get everything kind of in perspective is to see each other again. And to get a chance to hug each other again and talk to each other again. I always think you can tell more about each other when you can look at each other eye to eye, face to face. And I would love to see you eye to eye, face to face, and just be able to talk to you and answer your questions and just be with you. I think that would be really nice.
And you know,
nice.
It'd be good, Tammy, if we would know where this program is being seen.
Yes.
If you would let us know. We don't know how far the signal is reaching right here from the Houston area and where else. Ever is being picked up across the United States. A lot of you people are watching it on satellite, I'm sure. But would you write, Tammy, from wherever you're watching this? And to you folks that would like to have a copy of these shows, you might let us know about that. You may want to ship these things to other parts of the world, which I know there's people in London, there's people in Ireland, Holland, and Wales that have no Christian television.
Yeah.
They would enjoy having this.
I'm getting
this.
Ready to go to London, Roger, as I've been telling the people.
And you're going to sing that goofy
song.
I'm going
to sing, "If Life Had You a Lemon, Start Making Lemonade," to those folks in London. I'm going to walk Jesus right onto the set, in London of the Ruby Wax Show. Isn't that what it is,
honey?
That's
right, Ruby Wax.
I'm excited about that. God has given me some great opportunities to walk into the secular world, and I'm very grateful because that is where my burden is. My burden is for the sinners and for those who are hurting so desperately and need something to get a hold of. And that something that they're all looking for is what you and I have already found, the Lord Jesus Christ. And none of us should be afraid to walk into the world and to share the wonderful news of the gospel of Jesus Christ that we have found real to our hearts.
Amen.
Well, can you believe that this show is almost over already? I mean, they give me this 1 minute. I say, no, it's not possible. It can't be over yet. I don't want to leave you. There's my type A personality springing up again. Honey, hold me down. We want to thank all of our guests for being here. I love you all so much. We want to thank the worship and drama ministries of the First Assembly of God Church in Humble. Bill and Paula Stringer are the leaders there, and we want to thank you for coming. The puppets were wonderful. It brought back such wonderful memories to talk to the puppets again. We had a good time, and I hope that you had as good time as we did. I hope for just a little while you were a little kid again in your heart, too. You'll live longer and stay younger if you keep that little child inside of you alive. Well, remember, be good to each other. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you for being with us today. We would love to have you be a part of our live studio audience. For free reservations, call 713-212-1077. If you would like to write Tammy Faye, you may write her at P.O. Box 245, Rancho Mirage, California. That's 92270.
All this trial you're going through, your God's gonna show you just what to do. You can make